हेलो, इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद प्रीवियस डिस्कशन ऑन टू डायमेंशनल मटेरियल्स अदर देन ग्राफीन, वी हैव डिस्कस ऑलरेडी फोर डिफरेंट मटेरियल्स। इन दिस डिस्कशन आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक ऑन टू मटेरियल, दैट इज ट्रांजिशन मेटल चालकोजिनाइट एंड एमेक्सिन। सो फर्स्ट विल बिगिन विद ट्रांजिशन मेटल चालकोजिनाइट। So transition metal chalcogenide is having a structure or a formula MX2. They are also known as atomically thin semiconductors. And in this formula, M is basically a transition metal atom, which is MO and W, and X is a chalcogen atom, sulfur, selenium or tellurium. Few examples are MOS2, WS2, MOSC, WSC, MOT. 2. This material has direct band gap. There is also no inversion symmetry at K point. So they have a specific electronic properties known as the valetronics. Moreover, they also possess very strong spin orbit coupling. So this material is also very suitable for spin tonic behavior. If we think about the crystal structure, so since it's a basically different metals and also a different chalcogen material, so there is possible having a different crystal structure. Mainly they possess 3-1-T as kind of tetragonal symmetry, and the crystal structure is known as the octahedral. 2H, a kind of hexagonal symmetry, and the crystal structure is trigonal prismatic, and 3R is the rhombohedral symmetry, and the crystal structure is trigonal prismatic. If you see, it has again the 6 atoms similarly placed as in case of graphene, and has the, if you see, Brillouin zone, first Brillouin zone, so this is having a similar symmetric point K, sigma and M, but the placement of atom is different based on the crystal structure as 1T, 2H and 3R. Synthesis of this material is reported in the both way, top down approach as well as bottom up approach. Top down can be done by exfoliation process. Exfoliation is either surface assisted or intercalation assisted, or milling is also tried for top down approach. While in bottom-up approach, solid state synthesis, solvothermal synthesis, deposition and spin coating, mechanical alloying, sputtering, these kind of process has been demonstrated. So this picture can give a little bit more clear idea about top-down and bottom-up approach. This is presented in this review article taken from some other research article. And here you can see, if we have a bulk MOX2, it can be exfoliated by sonication and we can achieve the sheet, or it can be exfoliated by intercalation and we can achieve the sheet. The advantage is here we can get the large area synthesis, also the large size sheet. While in other hand, the bottom up approach is basically have nucleation and then growth, where this metal and chalcogenide atom react together at a vacuum or very high temperature conditions, and then they form the sheet of transition metal chalcogenide. Here we have better opportunity to control the lateral size dimension as well as the thickness of the sheet. So this is one of the study where they have demonstrated the dispersion of MOS2 and WS2 in water and ethanol mixed solution. An investigation shows very good result. They have demonstrated when 45% of ethanol was taken, if the solution is basically able to disperse the MOS2 particle very well, while in case of WS2, the 35% solution, ethanol solution, is sufficient to get the better dispersion, and respective absorption increase basically is also given here in this figure. So at 45% of ethanol, they are giving the highest absorption because the sheet are well dispersed. Similarly, at 35% of ethanol, they are observing the highest intensity of the absorption. Another investigations, a very simple experiment but very useful experiment was demonstrated. Here they have just controlled the speed of centrifuge. So you can see here, after sonication, if you are doing cleaning or how you are going to separate out the sheet, so for this separation they have just changed the RPM from 1.5 kilo RPM to, you can see, the 10 kilo RPM, and see how beautiful you can see the differences in the size. So if we are having just 1.5 kilo RPM, we are going to get very thick and large sheet, but while it increase from 3, 4 to 5, 7, 10, then we are going to get very thin and small sheet of the transition metal chalcogenide. So just adopting this strategy, we can even control the thickness as well as the size of the sheet. This is the another experiment where electrochemical approach had been demonstrated to fabricate the 2D layer transition metal chalcogenide. Here they have deposited a bulk transition metal chalcogenide over a copper foil, and then this copper foil used as a basically cathode material in lithium foil as the anode. And in this experiment, then after doing some charging and discharging, they are able to get the sonication, and then they basically did the sonication and then able to get the nanosheet dispersion. So after electrochemical intercalation, the composite on the copper foil was sonicated, since the lithium ion goes inside the bulk material and intercalation was happened. Then just by sonication they are able to get the nanosheet dispersion, and the experiment was further confirmed the result by doing atomic force microscopy, and in all case MOS2 or MOS2, WS2, TI, ZR, TA. So they have taken a different metal with the sulfur combination, and in each case they are able to get the two-dimensional sheet. This is the another approach where we can grow the transition metal chalcogenide sheet using chemical vapor deposition. This is given in this reference. And the experiment shows in CVD process there is a four different step. Step 1 is nucleation, step 2 is ripening, 3 is lateral growth, and 4 is when this is fully covered the surface. So at the beginning they use very high concentration which nucleate the transition metal chalcogenide over a substrate. Then meanwhile they stop this supply of WCO3 precursor. So this nucleation is happening in two-dimensional surface. And then a very small amount of WCO6 was supplied, so it initiated the lateral growth. And for if you supplying this precursor a longer time, then at least it covers the entire surface. Similarly, in the another approach, if you see the figure B, basically the growth of MOSE2 was reported, where selenium was taken in a boat, and then copper was basically molybdenum foil was taken and then top of the glass substrate. And here the experiment shows this molybdenum and selenium is reacted and they deposited over the melted glass. You can see this figure here. So the bottom is the MO, then top of the melted glass, and then top of that we are able to get the MOSE2. In the C, this is the again intercalation by using UNIMER assisted or maybe the micelle assisted experiment. So they again intercalation, these micelles or UNIMERs are going inside the layer, and then they are going to exfoliate that layers. So here I like this figure very much, which is given in TOC of this review article, and it shows this transition metal chalcogenide has very different properties as compared to the other material. And if you see here, the electronic property can be categorized in three different dimensions. One is spintronic, other is valetronics, and the third is strentronic. See, we already know spin orbit splitting is very much high in case of WSE2 or similar transition metal chalcogenide. So this material is very much useful for spintronics. Similarly, they are not having a symmetry at the K point because there is a band gap, and therefore the property of this K valley can be also utilized, and therefore the name is given as a valetronic. And the third point is, if we apply the strain in the system on this transition metal chalcogenide layer, then even we can tune the band gap. So this is also a kind of controlling electronic property just by applying the strain. So strain tonics is also. So this was the brief idea about transition metal chalcogenide. Now I will move to the last section, that is amexine. And this is again not a single material, it is a kind of family of materials. So that's why we are calling it amexines. And here, if we are having atom thick layer of transition metal with carbide or nitride, so basically transition metal carbides or transition metal nitrides or mix of these two, transition metal carbide or nitride, so then we are calling these material as amexine. And here the word basically ene is given just to make a similarity with the graphene, nothing else is there. And more than 60 plus member have been reported and discussed, and which comes under the metal carbides, carbonitrides or nitrides. And the basic formula or the composition could be M2X or M3X2 or MA4X3, where the general formula of amexine is given as Mn plus 1 Xn and Tx, and N can have a value of 1 to 3 atoms. So where M is the transition metal, that is Ti, Sc, Cr, Mo, Zr, Hf, Nb, Te, etc. X is either carbon or nitrogen, only these two or mix of these two. Again, the surface is open, so there is possibility to have some surface termination group such as oxygen, OH or fluorine. An example of amexine is Ti2C, V2C, Ti3C2. Nb2C, Nb4C3, etc. And based on their composition or this formula, let's say 3 metal then 2X2, 4 metal then 2X2, 1 kind of 2 metal then 1 metal atom then X2, 1 kind of 2 metal and then sorry 2 1 kind of metal and then 2 atom of other kind of metal with X3. These possibilities are there, and based on this the atomic arrangement can be understood here, where let's say one metal is associated with the four other nitrogen or carbon. So similarly, we can say based on this structure, there is a difference in the atomic arrangement, and accordingly that we are observing the different properties also. This is a very beautiful image given in this Chemical Society review, and what I can understand by looking this figure, like the two-dimensional material or particularly the amexine can be considered as a wing of a bird, and by using this wing, bird can achieve a very, very high height in the sky. Similarly, using this kind of amexine material, we may think for new and very advanced devices, and it can be applied for in future device applications. So how we can prepare the amexine? So again, it can be prepared by using top-down approach, similarly as in case of graphene, because we already having the MX phase. So precursor is possible to have in MX phase or also non-MX phase. And if you are talking about MX phase, so basically M is the metal, A is intermediate metal, and then X is the nitrogen and oxygen. For example, Mn plus 1, then aluminium is A, and then X. So depending upon the target amexine, we can select this composition precursor, what is the M and what X we know or we want. So let's say Al attaching MAX phase precursor, some other ion attaching is also possible, such as Ga and silicon. So we may have Mn plus 1 Ga Xn and Mn plus silicon Nx precursor for fabrication of amexine. And here are the few examples of the precursors, such as Ti3AlC2, Ti2AlC, Ti3C2 or Ti2C fabrication. So by using this kind of amexine can be fabricated. So in synthesis, basically we need to remove that A atom from MAX phase by etching of this. So we can consider it's a kind of glue which is binding with M and X. So how we can remove that glue from the material? So either HF or some acid fluoride kind of etching agent use to remove this glue and to get a single layer of this is stack. So a high concentration of FH solution react with attaching ions. It may be the aluminium or the silicon and cause MXG stack to deattach from each other. So just we are just dissolving this attached ionic bonding. But HF is little bit dangerous, very harmful. So avoid this. There are some other experiment was also reported where the scientists tried to substitute the HF reagent. So even in experiment was suggested like during the experiment if we can produce the HF. So in situ generation of HF through the reaction of acid with fluoride was also reported to etch out the aluminium or Ga. In another approach, there are reports which says molten fluoride with the assistance of high temperature heating are free F active enough to corrode the etching ion. So even just at high temperature if you have free F ion that can also etch out that glue. So we cannot, basically we should not use the HF, by without using HF we can also do the same thing. So either maybe the organic intercalation and metalline intercalation can also be performed, and by using this, considering the strong interlayer interaction with multilayer MXG, about 2 to 6 fold stronger as compared to that of graphite or bulk MOS2. So here little bit more energy need to be supplied as an intercalation or a metallation intercalation. So these kind of polar organic molecules are tried and have shown some experimental results. Similarly, the metal cations such as halide salt or metal hydroxide is also demonstrated as a tool to basically etch that atoms or glue ions which is basically binding between the metal and other layers. This structure shows what kind of possibilities are there, what kind of mix composition of MXG is possible. So one is a kind of mono element, means only one metal element with carbon or nitrogen. So structure may be M2X or M3X2 or M4X3 is possible. So maybe the layer can be changed. There is also possibility that we have the solid solution of M element, where one element is there and the second element is basically dissolved somewhere and the system is working as a solid solution. While there is also possibility order double M element, means it's not a solid solution with well order structure of one element of metal and then the second element of the metal. And this is the table which shows what kind of composition have been demonstrated. As we said, more than 60 plus compositions are given. So this color basically shows the experiment. So experimentally these things are reported. And then the light blue shows the theoretical investigation. So these are the theoretically investigated these materials. Similarly, double materials and others are investigated. I will suggest you just read this Chemical Society review article for further detail. Then now talk about the electronic properties. So electronic properties are very unusual because this is not only one material. Based on the composition and based on the metal, and maybe the mixed metal, it varies. The properties of MXG depend upon the nature of M as well as X, and then of course what kind of surface termination group is there. So the property may have the metallic nature, it may have the semiconductor properties, and also it has some kind of insulating properties. So we can say there is a great scope depending upon the requirement. We can select the material and then we can get the properties either metallic or semiconductor or insulating. So these kind of properties, further even this electronic properties of this MXG can be easily tuned by having a different kind of surface termination group or maybe the surface defect. Similarly, the optical properties also vary because we are having a different electronic property, and then absorption may be vary from even UV to NIR. That means it may have very wide band gap to very small band gap, and the band gap can also be tuned by just altering the surface termination group. And here, even in this particular case, let's say M2C, where M is TI, ZR, RF, the band gap was reported almost 0.92 to 1.75 electron volt. And MXGN also shows very good Raman scattering signal. So this material can be also used for plasmonic resonance or localized surface plasmon resonance behaviors or effect, and many sensing device and other application can be looked out. It also has luminescence. So few of the MXGN quantum dot have shown the luminescence, but when this particle size is very very small. This is the discovery which is basically shows the how the timeline of MXGN growth is happened. This is given in this research article. I would say you can just go through by this. So let's say it started at 2011, where the discovery of TI3C2 was reported by HFHing. Then in 2012, the family of MXGN was demonstrated. Then in 13, intercalation method came into the picture. Then in between 13 and 14, bifluoride base etching method was demonstrated. In 14, again the clay or small flag etching method was given. Then amine assisted delamination was reported in 15. Double M MXGN is reported in 16 and 17. Mild flag and order vacancies was reported. So these are kind of timeline how the quick progress happened in case of MXGN research. And this is the another area where the general map shows the fabrication of TI3AlC2, what kind of different etching method was adopted, like etching acid, whether HF or in situ HF. And if HF, then what was the basically the parameter, how long, what was the percentage. So let's say the 5 weight percent, the 24 hour, then 30 weight percent. So if we are doing this, what kind of output we are going to get, this is given here. Similarly, in situ case also, they have reported here, and then what kind of intercalation and sonication was there, that is reviewed. So very good review is given in nano research review paper. And if we talk about the application, so here this Chemical Society review focus only one kind of application, that is biomedical. Although this material is having application in very different areas, because you have more than 60 material, the properties is very very different. You have very different electronic properties, optical properties, and if we just narrow down the thinking, then even if we talk about biomedical applications, where we can use the electronic properties, optical properties and magnetic property, and numerous applications such as theranostic biosensors, antibacterial, bioimaging, and all these other applications are possible. And even they have also demonstrated antibacterial activities of the MXGN, where they have seen that this subtiles bacteria is, when coming into the interaction with MXGN, is basically become dead, and that they have given in this experiment. So that is all about the MXGN. So I will stop here, and I would suggest to read these suggested references for further understanding. Thank you very much. Thank you.